butter. No, we just plant some butter. Oh, me have mango, me have tamarind, me have custard apple, me have aki, me have no, me have not jumpla, me. Me have the plant, but me have soursop tree. Yeah. Oh. No man on the left. Left the bowling. The bowling. Well, okay, okay. So while we're about to start the second game, Ambassador Sports Club up against St. Bess Cricket Club. So Ambassador choose to take the field first. It's Keone Gale and Cornell Peart. And it's Orlando Johnson will be opening the bowling from the northern end, otherwise known as Lefty. Keone Gale along with Cornell Peart. So it's the first ball. You got the umpires who will be officiating today first ball from Johnson. That was a good ball. Plays back and they picked up a quick single. That one was played back past the bowler, but it was shied at the keeper's end. Hit the stumps, but umpire says not out. You got Vincent Artley and Brown, who is officiating today. This game has been talked about for quite a few months. And here we are today, both teams facing each other. Ambassador along with St. Bess. A swing and a miss there by Peart. Right, That was a good ball. Gale just stayed right behind it. That one played down to short, long off, to get a single. That was a good yorker there by Johnson. Get a leg by. It's the end of the first over. Score is 3 without loss. Ambassador. Temperature today should be about in the just about 89 degrees. Oh, it's a good day for cricket. Yeah. So while Trooper Gale is marching his troops, just coming off of the minor league, played for Fort Lauderdale Lions. He got a very good season. Went to the playoff. What was after 3 years, they were able to make it to the playoff, which is you could say a very good thing for the Lions. So it will be Samir Khan bowling from the southern end. A swing and a miss there by Peart. That one should be put away, but he misses. From play down to mid wicket, they get one. They're coming back for the second, but Peart decide he won't take that chance. And that was a very good throw into the gloves of Wallace. Score moves to 4 without loss. They're in the second over. This is a 20 over affair. You got a first slip, you got a third man, backward square. You got a man in the covers, a cover point, short cover. You got a man down there at long off, a short mid wicket, a deep mid wicket. And the man at short, long on, that was a good ball. A little short, get some bounce. Keone plays and miss. That was a quick single there. It's fielded by the bowler. Galen 2, Pearton 2, the score is 5. You can see Chupa is making some changes. Got a deep square leg, now we got a deep mid wicket. And a long off just halfway to the boundary. And that one was hit hard. And it's going high, and it's Chupa who takes a very good catch. Oh, that ball went real high in the air. You can see Chupa dries hands off and decide that, okay, I'm going to take this one. So Peart has been out, caught by Gale for 2. So Ambassador had lost their first wicket in the second over. And it will be the veteran popular known in South Florida as Juju, but his father's name is Ken Wright. And his name is Kenroy White. Right. Make a lot of runs here in South Florida in the past. Always be amongst the runs for South Florida. It's Johnson from, wow, that's a good ball. Right in the block hole, he's on target. can just, you know, where I'm blowing out, yeah. Yeah. And you can just put it here. So it's a very quiet start for Ambassador. They're in the fourth over and it's 7-1. That one was hit down to Cow Corner and he could be out. Yes, he's out caught by Sylvester Hickey. So Keone Gale has been out. So Ambassador is looking behind the eight ball. And it's replacing Keone Gale is Mark Supone Johnson. You can remember that name. I played for the US some years ago. Played several games for the US. Been their main opener and also their wicket keeper. Also a very good outfielder. But he's hoping that they could get a good partnership together along with Kenroy Wright. So the score is now Ambassador 7-2. They're in the fourth over. And that one was hit down to Cow Corner. It should go all the way, 4-4. So it's Samir to Mark Johnson. That was a good ball. Get some height. Johnson tried to steer it to the third man area, but it misses. So at the end of the fourth over, the score is 11-2, Ambassador.
What's up, big man? You good?
Yeah, sometimes we have some.
Hey, you know what I want to tell you?
No.
They say that. They say run out to bigger. Other yeah. Ones that like close, if they catch it close. As for me, that's the ball. You know, I keep on touching it and not the ball. To me.
Yeah, maybe. Hmm? Yeah, we can dry it up and maybe.
Yeah, my enemy.
Do I have your number?
No.
So right now, Sempest on top. Telling you, Sempest looking good. 2 wickets fall for Ambassador. Right now, the two legends inside him. The man Mark Supone Johnson and the man Ken Wright could never go wrong. So let's see what's going to happen. Thank you.
Yeah, all right, cool. Yeah, we'll link you. So while they were changing ball in from the northern end, it's Sean Finley, who had just been coming off of a good minor league season, went all the way to the final. But as they said, someone got to be the winner. That's a loud appeal for leg before umpire says not out, and the end of the over. Score is 13-4-2 after 5. 13-4-2, Ambassador. So it will be Samir bowling his third over. We're bowling to Mark Johnson. 13-2, Ambassador. Come on. That one, he just trickles around the leg side, picks up a single. Put the score to 14-2. So it's Ken Wright who is in one from six. And that's a swing and a miss there by Ken Wright, and it's a loud appeal. And the bowler thinks that he got his man, but umpire says not out. And he's now out, caught in the slips.
Here goes the wicket of the legend himself.
So,
the legend himself, the man.
Ambassador now is 14-3. Ken Wright had just been out, caught in the slips by Sean Finley. is Martin, who is making the way to the center to join Mark. It's Haldin Martin. I'm trying to stop the rut. .14-43, Ambassador. And that one was get an outside edge, and Finley were unable to hold on to it. Samir is getting a lot of bounce and turn. That one was it, hard and high. Down to the next field, 4-6 by Martin. So after six over, the score is 20-3, Ambassador.
This
because I come here talk with you now. Mm-hmm. It's a record.
Okay.
But at the same time, I mean, go home with that.
Take it out, yeah. Editing.
But it's like a way back out, make it to the movie. I said, wow, I'm more coming out here.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, YouTube. Mm. To the music man back home.
And it monetized, that's why.
Yeah.
And the page monetized, that's why.
Yeah,
the page monetized.
Yeah. Yeah, as soon as I edit it, put it up, tell me which music I'm going to go and go pick it up. But sometimes not much.
Yeah, I run through with a fine teeth comb.
And the thing is, when we take like 4 hours to edit and set up. When we put it on YouTube, we take another 4 hours. Put it on YouTube. Then come back and say, I have to go back and edit it again.
Time consuming.
Yeah.
I understand. If you got that much for me, you're the song in the area.
Just the music. If
you got that much for me,
yeah, we can be with the family.
I'm in a final and a road game, BTC, Mercury.
Yeah. And the legend Mark Johnson is outside there still. Back in the days, Super Bowl would have been 202. Yeah. But, you know, it's the old suit.
Yeah.
It's hardboard suit. I mean, not upstairs suit.
Knuckles. Yeah, damn views.
Yeah.
You love everything, man.
Just people are cars,
yeah.
When they're coming out of this time,
yes, sir. As I'm telling you, you know. I mean, they are not game, I'm going to watch it, you know, once we know it, once we know it, they hear your name, once we click on your name, go Ian, you
know. Mm, put this up like Tuesday, like, but maybe tomorrow, Tuesday. But, people that like me, people that make it, yeah. Like how you stop it now, then me that, go stop it.
Uh-huh. But you don't want to cut out of your
Yeah, I mean, right, so.
That no.
Yeah.
You walk it on your brand.
The only way is no music. No music. Yeah.
Even if you better, you tell your ass, yo, stop. Load the music in that day.
Yeah, but put it there. If the league bring the music out there.
Yeah,
so it's like,
the
league, if you understand, say, yeah. Listen.
And them now stream it live. And if them did stream it live.
It when I stream live, I'm saying, then stop now. Don't stop now. But it's the same thing them boy after. If them put it up, they must go take out their music then.
Damn it.
Yeah, go take out their music then. Because you see, a big cricket, they mean that one room where they hear the music outside.
Yeah.
So them can't play. I like the nice stadium. I'm in the nice stadium. I'm the upstairs. Like,
oh, like so music now, but I
said, yeah, because now you're it.
Oh, okay. So, youngster,
good. Look inside of it.
Right here?
Yeah. Looking at the back of the seat. This wonderful back.
I know, your Thursday was my birthday, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, but my birthday was last week. We have the club last week, you know. So.
I cannot believe the man picks in one pocket. Soup won't get bored from behind his back, I tell you. It's not soup anymore. It's, oh my God. It's only the soup, man. It's only the soup. Lord have mercy. There goes the legend.
Some people believe that have the tendency and say, listen.
Bad boss.
When I feel, when I run on ball twice, man.
No, man.
Yeah.
If this man ever bad boss, be dead.
Yeah.
Man, that.
As much as how it's slow right now, this man is going to move. Yeah, it's worse.
Yeah.
And when you look at this, you have to say, you don't get enough runs. You didn't born to ride or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
animal is going to do that. JC, JC, right, Valerie?
Thank you.
So while I return with some live cricket, it's Ambassador Sports Club. It's now 89 for 4. They're in the 13th over. They're going up against St. Best Cricket Club. We're here at Brian Piccolo, the North Field. And this is the South Florida Premier League Final, Division 2. Ambassador up against St. Bess. 89 for 4. Keone Gale, 3. Cornell Peart, 2. Kenway White, 1. Mark Johnson, 9. Aldean Martin is on 31. And Sean Finley on 34. Sean Finley is on the field. Sean Beckford is batting. Thanks for the correction. You got a current run rate is 6.76 and the projected score is 135. The current partnership is 65 off 35 balls. Tamar Blair, who is bowling at the moment. Sylvester Icky, who got 2 overs for 17 runs. And this is a good comeback by Ambassador. You got a partnership of 65. And he's out caught.
No ball.
And as they said, commentator curse. But this time, it's like it's a no ball called by Vincent Hartley.
Yeah, him call it before you.
And it's a no ball. I don't know what's the reason for the no ball. Okay, umpire said he overstepped. With those long legs of Blair, I think he realized. So it's and that one, he get an outside edge. They get one. They should come back for the second, but no, they decide not to, because who is going at it is Sean Finley, who is just coming off of the minor USA minor league. Played a good, very good season. Went to the final. So the score moves on to 91 for 4. They're in the, and he could be out caught. That's a beautiful catch there. I think that's let me see the fielder. I think it's Rowan. So Becky has been out caught. That was a good knock there by Sean Beckford. 35 from 19 with 5 sixes. So the score is now 92 for 4. Make that 92 for 5. And walking towards the center is Speedy, otherwise known as Cornell. .92 for 5, Ambassador are in the 14th over. Yeah, mango ginger. Homegrown mango.
Yeah.
one nice play.
Well, there's another change of ball in. It's Sean Finley again from the northern end, and he will bowl into Martin in the crease with Cornel White, otherwise known as Speedy. Outside the off stump, plays and miss, collect by Wallace, the keeper. From the keeper to Trooper, then to Johnson, back to the bowler.
Well, it dropped his cap, so it's going to be a dead ball. And we're still waiting to swing it on the off stump, if the ball is still again on the off stump.
Play to the leg.
Thank you.
Testing, testing. Cornel White has just been bowled by Blair. The score is now 99 for 7 after 17.3 overs. So it's O'Neill Walker is make his way to the crease to join Gary Parker. Parker is in 3 from 9. Tamar Blair now bowled 2.3 overs, 7 runs, 2 wickets. Orlando Johnson, who bowled his 4 overs, 1 maiden, 5 runs, no wicket. You wouldn't be able to ask for a better spell like that. 4 overs, 5 runs, including a maiden. So it's we're in the 18th over, so let's see if Walker could light up the place. But we'll wait and see. So it's Blair to, and he's out, leg before, and he's still standing, this believe, and I'm sure he would like to ask for a replay. Instead of talking to the umpire, he need to raise his bat and put his gloves underneath. That means they need a replay. That's a sign, right? Well, I will send him a replay in a couple of days from now. As usual, the batsman get out leg before and never think that he's out, but so Blair is on a hat trick. To the center is Tullock. Leon Tullock is just make his way to the middle. He's known for his sixes. While we got some clouds coming over, so it's Blair on a hat trick, and he could be out. Oh my! He spilled it. He spilled the hat trick. That should be an hat trick. But he spilled it. Let's see who is the, should I say the GOAT? It seems like it's I think that's Hunt. Blair still can't believe. But that's how it goes. As I said, the ball is round. I never know what's going to happen. The ball after ball. It's 101 for 8 after 7 after 18th over. You got a projected score of 112. The current run rate is 5.16. So Tamar Blair had bowled 3 overs, 9 runs and 3 wickets. From the north is Finley again. And it seems like there's a appeal for leg before, but it seems like there was a batting pad. So it's Finley bowling his 4th over. Swing and a miss there by Parker.
It's been an absolute it's been a while I've seen this much support in the West Indian community, West Indian culture.
Another swing and a miss. He's swinging across the line, not making contact, but luckily for him, the ball is gaining some height and Sam going over the stumps. It's Finley again to Parker, and now Parker plays straight, but he still misses. That one, now Parker were able to get some bat on, but he still got no run. That one, he get it over third man, they get one. And it's run away to the fence for four. So Parker finally get back to ball and get a top edge, and it went over third man for four. So the score moves on to 105-8 at the end of the 19th over. So with just one over to go. Ambassador, 105-8. Parker and seven from 15. Tallock and two from two. Sean Finley now ball is 4 over 9 runs 1 wicket, and I would assume that Blair will be bowling the last over, and is last over. He bowled 3 overs for 9 runs and 3 wickets, and that one he wait for the umpire to make a decision. It's a leg by, they get a single. So while I give you a rundown of the inning for Ambassador, Keone Gale, 3, Cornell White, Cornell Peart, 2, Ken Wright, 1, Mark Johnson, 9, Haldeen Martin, 33, Sean Beckford, 35, Cornell White, 2, Gary Peart, 7, O'Neill Walker, 0, Tullock, 2, Mark Leng, 2. He got 12 extras, 108 for 10 in 19.4 overs. In the bowling department, Orlando Johnson, 4 overs, 1 maiden, 5 runs. Samir Khan, 4 overs, 30 runs, 4 wickets. Sean Finley, 4 overs, 9 runs, 1 wicket. Riyad Mohammed, 1 over, 15 runs. Sylvester Ickey, 2 over, 17 runs. Brian Gale, 1 over, 16 runs. Tamar Blair, 3.4 overs, 11 runs, 4 wicket. And that sums up 108 for 10 in 19.4 overs. We'll wait for the second half because while we take an inning break, we got a little rain coming. So I'm hoping that it will clear up, but we'll see how it goes. We will be right back. Stay tuned. So while we're about to start the second half of the second game, Ambassador Sports Club would make 108 for 10 in 19.4 overs. It sent Miss Turn to top 109 in their 20 overs. Haynes Root Wallace, Samir Khan will be opening the inning for St. Bess. And it seems like it will be Leon Tullock will be opening the bowling for Ambassador. So Ainsworth Wallace will be taking strike. Be pretty much in form. And so while the umpire is getting ready, umpire Brown, along with Vincent Hartley.
So we are expecting a good flash innings here, where they can compete in like 15 overs, less than 15 overs. Let's see.
So Tullock, who is sporting the number 23 on his shirt, getting ready to bowl to Wallace. And Wallace hit that one, and it stopped in the grass because it's the grass is very heavy, but they were able to pick up two. So Ainsworth Wallace decided that he's just going to get it going. No reason to hang around, but this pitch is playing a little funny all day, but we'll see what happens. And as we've been mentioning, that one was played back over the bowler's head and dropped short of the fielder on the long on.
James Wallace
who is the Captain Martin. You got a slip, you got a third man, a short third man. You got a man square of the wicket on the offside. That one was played, it could run away for four. Yes. Down the leg, and it was turned around by Wallace for the first four of the game. So Wallace moved on to six from three. Score is St. Bess, six without loss, chasing 108 for 10 made by Ambassador. Another short ball, it should be a wide, yes, signaled by the umpire Vincent Brown. There is a question, though, that I don't understand why I would ask the question if the umpire can see the crease from where he's standing. He's like three-quarter way down to the fence. So it's from Tullock into Wallace. That one, he got hit on the thigh pad. That's down the leg, umpire signals a wide. You could hear someone shout for ball, which means that it was pretty close. I think that's the bowler. He's the closest one to the stumps in line. That's Tuller into Wallace. And that one he get a top edge. They could run away to the fence. Yes, it run away to the fence for four. He just open up the blade and just slice it over third man for four. So Wallace was always in his aggressive mood. Decide that he won't hang around. That one is down the leg and he flicks it out for Pard. They get one. He coming back for the second. Fielded by O'Neill Walker. We send the throw to the keeper Parker. The batsman went through for an easy two, and the score moves on to 12 without loss. St. Bess chasing 108 made by Ambassador. So at the end of the first over, the score is 14 without loss. And it will be Keone Gale. Bowling his left arm orthodox. He will be bowling to Samir. That's down the leg, umpire signals a wide. So it will be Wallace first in the first ball from Keone Gale. While they're making some adjustment to the field, we got a slip, we got a third man, a wide third man, you got a backward point. Wallace plays that one down to Langhorne for a single. And he's out, leg before.
Samir Khan didn't make any impact on this game.
Samir had been out. The first wicket is down for St. Bess.
Could you please explain to the viewers what's going on here? We know you have seen, you're playing international cricket, you're a legend for the West Indies. Tell us what's going on, Mikey, based on your point of view. Michael Olin, great, good afternoon, man. Welcome to South Florida.
I absolutely need my point of view. This is absolutely a drop-off game. We've seen two teams, they're playing absolutely tremendous cricket. And if they should get a wicket or two, it could be really devastated for this best team. Really good, talented team, really a deep batting unit. But we know that cricket is a game of glorious uncertainty. And if they can get a wicket or two, it could be devastated at this point.
We're gonna bring back to you the man from Lancashire, David Lyne. A really, really experienced IPL commentator. David, what's going on, Bumble?
Well, absolutely great cricket. It is in South Florida. We've got the great scene. You might be back in the day, Jeffy Boycott. It's great cricket. It's only 40 for two. It's a great sort of wicket. The batters are really playing well. The bowlers are getting the ball in the right areas. And that's what you want to see in the fundamental of cricket. It's great to see from the local lads.
That Australia game, man, they didn't live up to they didn't make 200. In a week, we saw the score like,
shot pitch delivery. Wallace was on the back foot in a flash and just guide this one down to back for a square for 4 runs. Score moves on to 44 for the last of 2 weeks.
The game loses at I think South Africa have a problem when they run into a Indiana, as I don't think them bowling is quoted, you know.
I'm gonna spin.
Absolutely critical.
No, drop in. Drop over. Yeah, okay, I thought it hit. Drop over.
I don't think the bowling is put in, no. Because you make 400 runs and then one and come back and make 300 runs. I don't think the bowling is put in, no. They run into Australia, England and those teams, they're going to have trouble.
They did make a lot, they lose.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, it's like the first time they make over 300 runs, they're thinking how much already, and then lose 300 and won't leave. I don't think I'm bowling is standing up. I run into one guy, see what's up. one of them Indians and was trying to make his own thing there. No, yeah.
That's the best they can ask for.
I forgot one of them team I saw was playing. He had one of them, he had put one of them cameras on the stump, but it's on the record. And then when they finish, you take it off and load it off.
Exactly.
But he said he was working on his own ball tracking.
Run rate.
Possible. Most everything in the pictures is mainly static, and you have to find out this one thing that's moving.
Demanding a backward final from the captain. And at the minute, the way he's bowling, he deserves to get whatever he desires at the minute, because he's the one that kind of keeping things steadily.
You know how video works, it's just a series of pictures. It's taking a picture, when they count frames per second, they're taking one picture every
60
frames per second, they're taking 60 pictures every second. Just like how you remember in school, people used to draw stick figures in the book, and then flip the pages, it looks like a movie. That's what video is. It's just a bunch of pictures, one after the other. So you take each picture and you try to find the ball in it. For the international matches, the camera has to be set up ahead of time, and it knows where the stumps are, and it knows certain markings on the free side. It knows certain things are.
Things of the man out. You know, when the man take the review, the man take the review, he's a missing stuff. He's a papa that go over and stuff. Because I think I say if Lee's would have been, his umpire's card, where he was. The RS. Yeah. Sometimes.
because you remember you only play computer.
Only 40 runs in 14 overs. It seems to be easy game from here.
You get one,
10 runs doesn't have to lose another wicket.
Yeah. It was the same thing with the DLS.
Yeah.
You see, a lot of these guys here, like they don't use DLS. Because first of all, they don't want to buy a computer.
So that is their first problem.
They don't want to buy a computer to come to a cricket match. Well, all of our umpires are telling me, you go to a cricket match, you have to have a computer. One of you have to have a computer. We don't like sending one. When we send one umpire to a game, it's very rare. We can't do any better. But we also, when we send two of them, so one of you has to have. Because if you can't go to a match and the match ends up where you need DLS and you don't, you're in some trouble with us. So that is the first thing they have, you know. So they wanted to use Quick Club DLS system, which when they calculate,
it's wrong. They don't have the license to keep up with it.
So we, like every time they make a change, Nero send us. This is the brand new DLS, like we have the 5.0 now. If I go to a cricket match and you're going to know that I'm a new cricket club, I'm going to let you check on it. Work that out and figure out what the chase is going to have. I'm going to tell them what's left in the DLS.
It doesn't matter because it's a full shot and heavy hit.
I tell him, I say, listen, you guys now tell me what you're going to chase. You understand? Because a lot of them understand the concept of a team, like a bat into a mat, rainfall, and you reduce the over. When you're done in the half, you set a target score. A lot of them don't understand that. The DLS will give you, but you set a target score because you lose X amount over. The game starts at a certain amount of over, and you lose X amount in it. You have a target score, now you have to set as the umpire. And even to calculate, you know, how many overs lost. That's some of the issues these guys have. They will say, no, we're not umpiring with them. They won't umpire to themselves.
But it scores again. This could be caught. This could be
It's on the line. It's put it on the line.
He doesn't even turn around. So how am I going to know? You understand? Because if he had turned around, he'd have probably have some idea that something is wrong here. Where is he?
He was way over and he was shuffling to get back in.
You see, the umpire don't turn around, and if you don't turn around, you don't know.
You all right, Speedy? You all right?
You okay?
Nice catch. Good catch, sir. Good catch.
Make sure you get out of
the pocket, man. Yeah! Oi! Remember now! Remember!
And this one here, you know?
Good thing I have seen Brian Gale, he never loses his wicket. He makes
make sure he finishes the game. So right now they need 30 odd from like 13 plus over. So I am confident that he's gonna finish up the game in less time.
Absolutely. It's not Russia, but
yeah.
It's a game that's really in control. That's the best.
Oh.
There's no doubt whatsoever that they should come out victorious in terms of leading 13. It's not Russia, but we've got two of the most experienced players in the tournament in China. Brian Tuba and Gale.
We're supposed to go down to the then they want to come to the master.
Yeah.
We know you're from the guy here.
Master
we can do your friend.
Pull this game off from Zephyr.
Not here in front of Mata.
Yeah, we're not going to your friend
neither. Yeah, I can't do it, man.
This is possible. I don't think it is possible. It's so it's pretty good. At the minute, Zephyr are really in control.
After the
situation, Finley goes almost presenting a turn to the lineout. Backward point.
Yeah, but he's a backward point.
That's the thing that Steve's not playing on the CP. You don't feel well.
Comes and this is in the air, that's running down to backward point. It should go back too easily. Congratulations to America Grove Cricket Team for winning the Division 1 Championship. Outstanding performance from Brooks, the man himself who picked up an hat-trick. Got 5 wickets in the final consecutively. Really bright talent. So at the end of 7, the score moves on to 81 for the last 4 wickets.
So St. Bess is now 96 for 5.
A lot of tactics going on from Ambassadors, but it's only a few runs needed.
Brian Galen 8 and Riyad Mohammed in 1. Still need another 13 runs from 11 overs with 5 wickets in hand. St. Bess chasing 108 made by Ambassador Sports Club.
The beauty of this game is both the teams, whether they win or lose, they're going to play in Division 1. The tough teams in Division 1, they qualified to Division 1 already. That's a good ball, that's a good leave. Glorious shot from Riyadh. It's only 5 runs. runs more needed. One shot away from the victory from Division 2. Ambassadors did very best to get 5 wickets, but they have to control the runs. Right now it's almost over.
You're rougher, man. All the people are rougher. Rougher. We want you to come and join the rougher as the game done, please. The rougher. Rougher, man. All the people who promote in the rougher. I want you to come in right now. The game is about to be over. I want you to come in and enjoy your rougher. Because people need to go home.
Thanks so much for God.
You guys don't want to wrap up, don't want a refund, okay?
Thanks so much for Michael Holding, Clay Lloyd. They went wonderful at the comment box. Back to Ravi Shastri and Sunil Gavaskar. Look at the game, it's one-sided domination. Sempest having ample time to get the 5 runs needed in 9.2 overs. They have the cup in the pocket.
Drop it.
Another ground shot, another speed. Ambassador should have got 6 by now. Anything would have happened with the last 4 runs, but then they dropped the catch. One shot away from being victorious and lifting the trophy from Division 2. That's a good shot, no fielder outside, could be an easy 2 runs. Fielder jogging, the batsman running. They are getting 3 runs, easy 3. End of the over 11, scores are tied. Sempest are 108 for 5. They are one ball away, one shot away from lifting the trophy from Division 2.
Game. Sempest 1, Division 2. It's an all-ball court. one.
You want to help with everything before we leave?